Welcome students, myself Mayank Pasha, and today in this session we'll solve the problems of exercise 4.3 of understanding quadrilaterals. Students, now let us solve the first question. Okay, so what they have given? Given a parallelogram ABCD, complete each statement along with the definition or property used. Students, here they have given parallelogram. Okay, so this is a parallelogram ABCD, and here they have given some questions and we need to solve them using property. Okay, and we need to solve this, and we need to state which property we have used. Okay, now let us take the first one, that is AD. AD equals to what? We have given dash, no? So now we know, students, that opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. So here AD, this is one side. Okay, so AD is a side. We know that opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. If this is a side, means then which is the side opposite to this? Obviously this, no? Okay, so if this side we have considered, means which side is opposite to this? That is BC or CB, you can write. So AD equals to BC, I am writing. Which property we have used, students, here? Opposite, okay, sides of parallelogram, this is the shortcut, parallelogram, are equal. Okay, opposite sides of parallelogram are equal, then AD is equals to BC and DC is equals to AB. Next, this one, that is angle DCB equals to what? Angle DCB, that is angle DCB means this angle. Okay, angle DCB means this angle, DCB, this angle. So this angle is equals to what? That is, we know that not only opposite sides as well as opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Okay, opposite sides as well as opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. So if we consider angle C, then which is opposite to this? You know, okay, angle A is opposite to angle C. Okay, then what we can write? DCB equals to DAB. Okay, which property we have used? Opposite angles of parallelogram are equal. Okay, opposite angles of parallelogram are equal, then DCB equals to DAB. Next, students, which is this one? OC equals to what? Okay, so OC means this part, students. Okay, so here I have not drawn the line straightly. Okay, the lines must be what? Straight. So OC means this part. OC equals to what, students? Obviously OA or AO. Why? Because diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. Diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other means, students, what is that? Okay, it means that the diagonals of a parallelogram divide the lines into equal parts. That is OC equals to OA. Okay, that is diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. Okay, diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. Students, now let's solve the fourth one, that is the sum of two angles, that is angle DAB and angle CDA. The sum of this angle, that is angle DAB. Okay, angle DAB. DAB means this angle. Next, CDA. CDA means this angle. Okay, so whichever the letter is in the middle, no, it represents that angle. Okay, So angle CDA means this angle, and angle DAB means this angle. Then here what they have asked, what is the sum of these two angles, that is angle D and angle A. Okay, so we know that in a parallelogram the sum of adjacent angles, okay, the sum of adjacent angles of a parallelogram is what? 180 degree. Okay, the adjacent angles of a parallelogram are supplemented, means 180 degree. Sum of adjacent angles of a parallelogram is 180 degree. Okay, sum of adjacent angles of parallelogram is what? 180 degree. Students, now let us solve the second question. Okay, so what they have given? Consider the following parallelograms. Find the value of unknowns, that is x, y, z. Students, in the given parallelogram, so what we need to find? We need to find the value of the unknowns, that is variables x, y, z. Okay, so now let us solve the first question. Okay, so look at here, students. Observe the figure carefully. So here ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, angle Z, X are opposite angles, and they are given angle B as 100 degree. Then angle Y we don't know. Okay, so now we need to find the value of X, Y, Z. Then how to find, students? Okay, so we know that the opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal, and we know that the adjacent angles of a parallelogram is what? The sum of adjacent angles of parallelogram is what? 180 degree. Okay, so first we'll solve this one, that is angle ABC means, students, angle B. Okay, so don't confuse. Angle ABC means angle B, B center now, equals to angle CDA. Okay, students, angle ABC equals to angle CDA, that is angle D. Angle B is equals to angle D. Why? Because these are the angles of parallelogram. Okay, so these are the opposite angles of parallelogram. So now they are given angle B as 100 degree now. So if the angle B is 100 degree, then it is understood that angle D is equals to what? It is also 100 degree. Why? Because opposite angles of a parallelogram is what? Equal. Okay, therefore angle CDA, okay, angle CDA, that is angle CDA means what, students? Y, no, that is Y is equals to 100 degree. Okay, angle CDA means angle D is equals to what? They are given Y, no, so it means that Y is equals to 100 degree. Now this one will solve. Okay, we'll find the value of X. So here we'll write the statement, students. Okay, opposite angles of parallelogram are equal. Okay, so we'll write the statement. Next, students. So angle ABC. Angle ABC means which angle, students? Angle B plus angle BCD. Angle BCD means, students, angle C equals to 180 degree. Okay, so the sum of these two angles must be what? Equals to 180 degree. Why? Because these are adjacent angles. Okay, sum of adjacent angles is 180 degree. Then, students, ABC means how much is there? 100 is there. Plus BCD means what? X equals to 180 degree. Then X equals to, transpose this 100 here, so it will become minus. X equals to what? 80 degree. X is equals to 80 degree. Students, as X is equals to 80 degree, that is angle BCD. Okay, that is as X is equals to 80 degree, it means that this angle, that is DAB, that is the value of Z is equals to what? It is also 80 degree. Okay, so we'll write here angle DAB equals to BCD. Okay, what opposite angles this is of parallelogram are equal. Okay, angle is what, students? Z. That is Z equals to X. That is Z is equals to what? X is equals to what, students? 80 degree, no? Okay, as angle DAB equals to BCD. Okay, DAB equals to BCD. As this angle is equals to this, okay, that is as Z is equals to X, so we have got X as 80 degree. It means that Z is equals to 80 degree. Okay, so here the value of X is what? 80. Y is what? 100 degree. And Z is what? 80 degree. Students, now let us solve the second question. Okay, so here they are given the parallelogram. Okay, so here they are given the parallelogram. So here this angle is 50 and we need to find the value of X, Y, Z. Students, you know the properties of parallelogram, no? So with the help of that, we can find the value of the variables, that is X, Y, Z. So look at here, students. The sum of this angle and this angle must be equals to 180 degree, or the sum of these two angles must be equals to 180 degree. Why? Because these are adjacent angles. Okay. So here 50 plus X equals to 180 degree. Adjacent angles of parallelogram. Okay. Why the sum of these two equals to, why the sum of these two angles are equals to 180 degree? Why? Because these two angles are adjacent angles. Then X equals to, okay, 180 degree. Bring this here. First to 50. Then X equals to 20 plus 50 is 130. Okay. Then, so here the value of X is what, students? 130. Then we need not to find the other. Okay, just look at here. If this is, okay, if this is 130, means this angle is also 130 degree. Why? Because these are the opposite angles of a parallelogram. Okay, and if this is 130, means this angle is also 130. That is Z. Why? Because these are the corresponding angles. Okay. Angle X equals to Y. Angle X equals to Y. That is opposite angles of parallelogram. Why these two angles are equal? Because these are the opposite angles of parallelogram. X equals to Y means X is what? 130 degree. That is Y is equals to 130 degree. Okay. And what I told you, X equals to Z also. X equals to Z, okay, corresponding angles. Why these two are equal? Because corresponding angles, these are corresponding angles. That is, if X is the, if the value of X is what? 130 degree, then Z is equals to what? It is also equals to 130 degree. Okay, so here the value of X as 130, Y is also 130, and Z is also 130. Students, now let us solve the third question. Okay, so here this is also a parallelogram and we need to find the value of X, Y, Z. So here they have given the angle as 30 degree. Okay, now so look at here, students. So this is the, which symbol this is? It is 90 degree symbol. Okay, so this is what? This is 90 degree. And if this is, this angle is 90 degree, okay, so if this angle is 90 degree, then it means that this angle must and should be 90 degree. Okay, so this, if this angle is 90 degree, then it is also 90 degree. That is, the value of X is what? 90 degree. Why? Because vertically opposite angles. Okay, x equals to 90 degree vertically. Vertically opposite angles. Okay. Now students, so look at here. We have got the value of x as 90 degree. Why? Because vertically opposite angles. Now, in this triangle, students, okay, so this is a triangle now. So in this triangle, this is 30 degree. And this is how much? 90 degree. And what is this? We can find the value of y now using angle sum property of triangle. Okay. So here, x plus y plus 30 equals to 180 degree. Why? Because sum of angles of a triangle is what? 180 degree. Okay. Sum of angles of triangle. Now students, so here we have got x as 90 degree. 90 plus y plus 30 equals to 180 degree. Okay, then 90 plus 30 is how much? 120 plus y equals to 180. So y is equals to 180 minus 120. Then y equals to how much? 180 minus 120 is 60 degree. Okay, so here the value of y is what? 60 degree. Now look at here, students. So this we have got 60 degree, and this we have got how much? That is 90 degree. Okay, and this is what? 30 degree. Now students, so we need to find the value of z. Okay, so here z will be equals to y. Okay, so z will be equals to y. These two angles are equal. Why? Because alternate angles. Okay, so these two angles are alternate angles. That is y equals to z, because alternate angles. Okay, so y is equals to z. Why? Because it is there, these are alternate angles. If here y is equals to 60 degree, then z is equals to what? Z is equals to 60 degree. Okay, for this problem, students, so value of x is what? 90 degree, y is 60 degree, and z is also 60 degree. Students, now let's solve the fourth question. Okay, so here they are given the parallelogram. So this angle is what? 80 degree, and we need to find the value of x, y, z. Students, so how to find? Okay, so look at here. So if this is 80 degree, means this angle will be also 80 degree. Okay, so if this is 80, then the value of z is also 80. Why? Because so these are corresponding angles. Okay, and if this is 80, means the value of y, okay, so this is also 80. Why? Because these are the opposite angles of a parallelogram. Okay, if this is 80, okay, then we can find the value of x. Why? Because the sum of adjacent angles is how much? 180 degree. Okay, so here z is equals to 80 degree corresponding angles. Okay, z is equals to 80 degree, and y is equals to 80 degree. Okay, so y is equals to also 80 degree. Why? Because opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Okay, y and 80 degree. Okay, so this one, y and this angle is, these angles are opposite angles, no? Okay, so if this angle is 80 degree, means then this also angle, then this angle is also 80 degree. Why? Because so these are opposite angles. Now, so we know that y is what? 80 degree. Then we can find the value of x easily. Okay, so y plus x equals to 180 degree sum of adjacent angles. Okay, so because this, as these two are adjacent angles, the sum of these two angles is how much? 180 degree. Then y is what? 80 degree plus x is equals to 180 degree, x is equals to 180 minus 80 degree, x is equals to 100. Okay, so here the value of x is 100, y is 80 and z is 80. Students, now let's solve the fifth question. Okay, so this is a parallelogram. So this angle is how much? 120 degree and this angle is 40 degree. Okay, students, look at the figure carefully. So if this angle is 120 degree, then this angle is also 112. Why? Because opposite angles of parallelogram are equal. Then this is 40 degree. Okay, now we can find the value of x with the help of angle sum property of a triangle. Okay, why? Because we come to know the value of y and so this angle is already given. Okay, and when we get the value of x, then we can get the value of z. Okay, so now y equals to 120 degree, that is opposite angles of parallelogram. Okay, so these are the opposite angles of parallelogram. You can write here r equal next 40 y plus 40 degree plus x equals to 180 degree sum of angles of a triangle. Okay, y we have got as 112 plus 40 plus x equals to 180 degree, then 112 plus 40 will be 152 plus x equals to 180. Okay, next x equals to 180 minus, transpose this towards right side. Okay, so 152, x equals to 180 minus 152 is how much? 28 degree. Okay, students, here we have got the value of x as 28 degree. Now x equals to z, this x equals to z. Why? Because these are alternate angles. Okay, alternate angles. If x equals to z means, so here x is what? 28 degree. Then z is equals to what? 28 degree. Okay, so here we have got the value of y as 112 degree, x and z as 28 degree. So let's now solve the third question. Okay, so what are given? Can a quadrilateral ABCD be a parallelogram if the following conditions satisfies? Okay, so here they have given some conditions. Here they ask some conditions or questions. Here parallelogram for the following conditions or not. Okay, so here the first one is what? Angle D plus angle B is equals to 180 degree. So what they are asking means, so if the sum of these two angles is 180 degree, then will this be a parallelogram or not? Okay, so these angles, that is angle D and angle B, are opposite angles. Okay, so we know that opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Okay, so opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. So but the sum of opposite angles of a parallelogram is not 180 degree. Okay, the sum of opposite angles of a parallelogram is not 180 degree. Okay, so here angle D plus angle B is not equals to 180 degree. Okay, so here they are given equals to 180 degree. It means that this condition is not satisfies. Okay, if this condition is there means, then it will not a parallelogram. Okay, it can be suppose. Okay, so it can be suppose we have written the another way. Okay, another order. It can be but here it is not. Students, here, okay, so in place of A, if we would have written B, then then angle D plus angle B is equals to 180 degree. Okay, angle D plus angle B is equals to 180 degree. Why? Because adjacent angles of parallelogram is equals to 180 degree. But here we have to go cyclic order. A, B, C, D. We should not write here B. Okay, so we have to go cyclic order. So when we go cyclic order, so we are getting D and B are opposite angles. And we know that the sum of opposite angles is not 180 degree. Okay, so it's not 180 degree. Then look at here. So it can be. Okay, so in some cases it can be. How it can be? If you would have written B here, but it is not possible. Okay. But it is not possible. Students, now we'll see the second condition. Okay, so what they have given? AB equals to DC equals to 8 cm. That is AB equals to DC equals to 8 cm. Okay. Next, AD is equals to 4 cm. And BC is equals to 4.4 cm. Okay. So they have given that if AB is equals to and DC is equals to 8 cm and AD is equals to 4 cm and BC is equals to 4.4 cm, whether this can be a parallelogram or not. Okay. Just observe the figure carefully, students. Okay. So when we observe the figure carefully, then we will come to know that this cannot be a parallelogram. Why? Because we know that opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. Okay. As these two are the opposite sides, these are equal. Okay. So these are equal. And now look at here. These two sides are also opposite to each other. So these two sides are opposite to each other. And these two sides must be equal. But what they have given, this is 4 cm and this is 4.4 cm. So it cannot be possible. Okay. As the opposite of a parallelogram are equal, okay, it cannot be as opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal, it cannot be possible. Why it cannot be possible means here the opposite sides of a parallelogram are not equal. Let's not solve the third question. Okay, so here they have given A is equals to 70 degree and C is equals to 65 degree. That is A is equals to 70 degree and C is equals to 65 degree. If A, what they are asking, if A is equals to 70 degree and C is equals to 65 degree, whether this can be a parallelogram or not. Just look at the figure, students. So say that whether this is a parallelogram or not, obviously it is not. Why? Because we know that the opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Okay, so as here the opposite angles are not equal, then it is not a parallelogram. Okay, as the as the opposite angles are not equal, it cannot be possible. Okay. So as the opposite angles are not equal, it cannot be possible to be a parallelogram.